We have a men's doubles now. Oliver Leighton Davis from New Zealand and Lasse Moed from Denmark, Peter Briggs and Tom Wolfenden of England. They're the third seeds. I've never seen any of these English boys play, have you, Ray?
Oh yes, very good, and they've been getting a degree of success in Europe. Been a partnership for quite a while, and following in the slipstream now of Marcus Ellis and Chris Langridge. They've got really good role models to follow and compete against.
What would you say was the most important thing, Ray, in the moment?
Still, as it always has been, Dan, in my opinion, serve and receive. You've got a few different shots. I think the angle of the smash is quite important now, and to vary the angle of the smash. But definitely, in my opinion, would be serve and receive, and you'll see that they won't be giving the lift away. In fact, the English pair are a real classic style of doubles. They really, it's pretty quick, it's very flat a lot of the time, all laying off the shuttle to get the lift. They're very intelligent players, and you can see the way they're knocking up. It's all about getting used to the pace, and because that's what they're immediately going to go into when they go into this game. And this is how doubles players practice for hours on end, just doing this fast reaction work. And you, Dan, what's
No, I was just stalling for time there. I knew that would get me a good 3 minutes if I asked you that anyway. I've got that many pairs of glasses here. I'm getting so old now. I feel like something out of a quick change artist routine here, swapping from one to the other to try and read names.
Quite interesting to see a New Zealand player playing with a Dane. I'm sure there's a backstory there.
Yeah, in answer to your question, Ray, I think it's speed and power here. Quality of serve, second and third shot. And then, of course, you have to have a brain to know where to hit, to try and bring your partner into the game at the forecourt. If you're at the back hitting power, you're trying to get weaker replies to bring them into the match and let them hit the winners at the front. If your smash gets through, then it's a bonus, but the defences are so good nowadays, rackets are so light. It's definitely reaction stuff. Speed of hand.
The front player plays such an important role in stopping the shuttle, getting the lift. Briggs looking very comfortable in defence there. And there was that sort of sharper smash that I was really cut down, not going as far back into court as you might expect, and then it set the net player up.
Yep, good change. Overhead there.
Nice serve from Briggs again. Serve was a bit loose, and I think that would have been out.
Hey, come on.
That's not. The thing I find interesting is watching anyone who comes here to the Emirates Arena in Glasgow to watch. You see the players, the amount of talking they do to each other, and yet you go to any club in the country and you hardly see them speak a word to each other before they serve or anything. So they will be telling each other where they're going to serve to, so the players must have a lovely shot there. That's an awful shot.
The other thing you see is it's just like the boys there, they sort of slap the hands and everything like that. So they're constantly giving each other positive feedback to each other.
Yeah.
Trying to lift their partner up all the time. You don't always see that in club badminton, that's for sure.
And they're very much a partnership, that they know they've got to play for each other to try and get the result they're both looking for, which is a win and progress to the next round. Yeah, see them talk again. I think there may be a mishit there, yes, he's burst a string. Just mistimed the flight of the shuttle and overstretched for it. And just for all you club players out there, if you burst a string anywhere near your frame, it's your fault. It's not the stringer's fault, it's your fault. If the string goes in the middle, then it could be a fault with the string, but if it's through time, then you're a quality player. Mr. Stevens on my right just took great pride in showing me his rackets last week from all the feeding that he does. Both the strings had gone right in the middle of the racket. Well up.
Oh, that's
off. That's good, he won't do that. He needed some shoes on his knees there to help him to get along the floor there to get that one.
I coach at a club at the moment, Dan, and there's a dozen youngsters there that I'm coaching, all quite reasonable players. Four have asked me to teach them to dive, and that's, you know, you might see Lin Dan dive, etc., but believe me, there's no future in diving, because the next shuttle, you're not going to get it back. Five, three. Gonna be on balance.
Unless you're Lin Dan.
Unless you're Lin Dan.
You can bounce it. But yeah, that's I was saying earlier that for me, balance is everything. If you're balanced, you can play quality. If you're off balance, you don't have quality.
There you're seeing a setup again, and you'll see this quite often. It's a big part of this pair's game. Having said that, it's very even at the moment.
It's anyone's game at the moment. Very tight match. Good serving, and see how quick he was on the net. As they come forward, because they're not able to take the shuttle above net height, he's really hunting the tape here. That was very good. Oh, and that's a planned routine there. Serve to the middle, and then the back player moved up the court looking for the push straight.
They really are producing a lot of power off there. Backhand drives down.
Yep, most players practice that. Not enough practice, in my opinion, on forehand returns, but A lot of players can't change from side to side, but the boys will do, as you know, thousands of multi-feeds to get that power and pace able to generate it off a short action.
If you went into a national centre and you saw doubles players playing, I would say 50% of the time is taken up with sort of fast driving. Sort of rally you're seeing here.
Very good angles there from the English boys.
I think it really has become who gets the attack now in this game. Oh.
Serve and good return. He was slightly unlucky because he was looking for it, just didn't manage to get it over.
That would have been a classic third shot, wouldn't it, really?
Yep. Brush just going long there.
Rack it up to the net, really hunting the shuttle. It's interesting, Dan, they're going to be changing the service law, so it's done from a fixed height. So it's sort of favours shorter players and goes against tall players, really. That's coming in.
That'll make it a bit interesting when you're watching some people trying to serve. That means the advantage of being tall has gone.
Absolutely.
Interesting. Are they moving the front line back? As you seem to be the fountain of all knowledge here in this way.
Well, the other thing that is just happening, they've just had a BWF meeting and they're looking at changing the scoring system. It won't happen till next May, but... people can expect a change in the scoring system. 5 points to 11, which not everyone's in agreement with. So this could well be the last Scottish Open Grand Prix you're seeing played to 21.
Do you think that'll affect how people train for the game, Ray?
Well, the big change in scoring system happened to rally point scoring in 2006. So you're talking 11 years ago now. And it definitely changed the game. The game was looking for quick points, etc. Became a bit more attacking, etc. But now... all the players are settled down and the standard is at such a level now that it's got back to rallying, and you've seen games like there is at the World Championships where it does sort of come back into the longer game plan, which I think should be there personally, but this will be pandering to sponsors, TV, the betting systems that there are around now.
Just for, you mean shorter, more exciting games?
Yeah, more pressure points pressure within points, the match. Yeah. I think they should leave it alone, personally. I mean, some of the quality of the badminton that we're seeing here and the quality of the badminton that we're seeing at the recent World Championships. The stand is so high now. Over, 13, And I really would urge people that if they want to see top quality badminton, you know, it's here at the Emirates. Please come along. The tickets are so reasonable and you would get to see real top quality play. There's a little break of 3 points now, and that is a break when you're playing to such fine margins as these boys are out here. Oh, what a shot. I was counting the number of times that it actually changed from attack to defence in that rally, and it was three clear changes, and it just goes to show how they're looking for the spaces. English boys a little bit defensive there and paid the price. Seeing these very fine angles from the English boys there, not paying any dividends, but they were doing the right things. But they're going to be pushed to get back in this set, 5 points adrift.
That was very quick, Ray, at the front there. He served and good return, and he intercepted it, putting the pressure on the English boys. Be interested to see if he flicks again. He flicked the last time and they won the point. You see them moving for that. That's definitely, they've got them sussed here, what they're doing. He just serves to an area and the back player moves cross court.
Yeah, I'm very impressed with the partnership. Oh, that's sharp.
Yes, he's very quick at the front of the court, and that's a lesson for all you badminton players out there. If you can serve well and people are coming at the shuttle with their racket below the height of the tape, you've got to get your racket up and hunt that net. And you'd see a lot more of that happening in club badminton if people did it, but they don't. They just watch the shuttle go over the net, their racket stays at their ankles, and then they end up having to lift a net shot instead of knocking it downwards. I was very impressed with the New Zealand-Danish partnership at the end of that game, Ray.
Absolutely. They've just rushed the points through, didn't they? But all really from good serving, Dan. It's that's a real basis of it.
Yep, when someone can serve to you, they have a chance to beat you if you're taking it below tape height all the time. And the young Dane there in the camera, he was with the shuttle. I was very impressed with him at the forecourt toward the business end of the game. Yeah, but both these players upped their game there when it got tight. So there's a tough road ahead for the English partnership now. Judgment there, leaving the shuttle, and it was well in. At this level, it was well in.
So it brings them Wolfenden. They've got good defences, but I think that would be the wrong game plan against this pair. Far better to look for the attack.
Unless you're under physical pressure or whatever, if you're getting tired, I can't see any way that you would want to be lifting the shuttle in the modern game. You'd be wanting to keep it going downwards if possible. Unless, of course, when the players lift to you and then move forward, then you have to go over them. But problem for the young Danish player. His leg, I don't know what happened.
Very good serve there.
Good defence in there, good cross defence from the English player.
And again, there was three changes from attack to defence in there. Just goes to show they're pretty proactive in there and looking for the defence, looking for the attack, sorry.
Clearly just changing the angle of the shuttle coming. The New Zealand player forced the error.
Getting another good serve, great return. Close. And he could put more power in that, but what he does is he slices his smash, cuts it down, Briggs. It was a really good move, that.
Good accurate shot.
Oh, that's sharp. Very impressed with the New Zealand boy, Dan. He's very good.
Yeah, he was quick there. I wasn't impressed with Briggs' net shot there, but he was very quick.
See a lot of winners going down the centre of the court here, which is always a good tactic in men's doubles. Play to the centre of the players. This court, then there's not one player that's below 6 foot.
Yeah, they're four tall chaps.
That's something you wouldn't see in a men's doubles too often, a slow drop.
It was certainly snow on that shuttle coming down. It was so high. I don't know what happened to his technique there. It was a very poor shot.
So gap opening up here. Just getting the impression that they can push through the New Zealand boy, but not the Dane. They're able to get through him because he's not sharp on that net on either when he's got them under pressure. Whereas the Danish boy is really sharp. Oh!
The English pair have up to pace here, Ray. I think they're attacking more than they were.
Yeah.
And it's paying dividends for them. And I was just going to qualify that by saying, but I didn't think that the other two had been hitting as hard as they were before. But that one was a very good hit. Went through the defence completely.
Pretty solid. I don't think you're going to see that too much, that someone's able to defend and win a point.
Aidan Davis's style, he looks quite like, was it Thomas Lundgaard?
Yeah, do you know, I actually thought that earlier on. I thought that just looks like one of the old Danish players, and that's exactly the one I was thinking of.
I wonder if he plays at the club that he's at, if he's at a club in Denmark. Doubt Nathan's out there saying, keep it going, do what you're doing, keep attacking.
Must be pretty good to be getting advice from a silver medalist in the Olympics and a previous world champion.
Sure, it doesn't come much.
That's the best way round with the New Zealand boy at the back and the Dane at the net.
Yeah, without a doubt.
Very, very sharp.
Yeah,
the
I
Danish
think the
boy.
Dane is very nine, quick coming out of the shuttle.
Yeah. And this is a fierce men's doubles, Dan. What I would like people to do who are watching here and really interested in the game is they're going to take a stance in a moment of serve and receive. Look where the rackets are. Look where the rackets are for all of the players on the court. So receiver, the rackets up. The defender at the back, the rackets up. Everyone's got the rackets up at net height. And that's what you don't see in lower level badminton. Oh! That was good interception by Brooks.
Yeah, and it was timely as well, Ray, because that stopped a little bit of a downward spiral for them there. They hadn't won a point in four or five anyway. Stopped the run.
Oh, that's out.
Service over. 12-4. So you, sometimes I wonder when I watch modern men's doubles, you see them do all this fast stuff and they do it so well, and there's just a soft shuttle and he lifts it out the door.
I think Wolfenden's a very good player, but last two shots he's made,
that's a lovely shot there from the
it was. So much power just from a short action like that.
He's so good at the front. So impressed with him. I haven't seen him miss anything coming to him at the net. 14-12.
Short list, but the tactics we're trying to input into this screen here, the short lift there was from the New Zealand boy, so you're going to get the poor decisions in the match off of him, not off the Dane, and I make you 100% right that if I was playing with you, Dan, we'd be hitting the New Zealand boy. If ever I mean exactly today, Dan.
That's a nice shot.
Strong off their back end.
Oh! I'm sure he came over the top of that as well. Love it.
Takes real skill, that sort of shot. Well, very difficult position for a very good English pair.
Yes, they are the number three seeds, the English pair. It's going to take a tremendous effort from here to win this game. That's a nice shot. He changed his grip completely for that, and then a simple error. That was very good there from the English boys coming forward, very good. But see there, Ray, I don't know if were you watching that, were you paying attention there?
No,
his racket, he's hitting and his racket goes away down his feet. I can't understand that. The rackets are so light.
Asking me if I was watching it, and you was asking me a question, who did Nathan Robertson look like as the English comedian, and I said Russell Brand, so, you know, still put me off.
I was still asking you and watching what was going on.
Oh, well, I can't do two things at once.
So putting in a good shift.
What a super shot.
That was a lovely shot. And then again, stopped the rot there. Pressure back on the English pair.
Such a pressure situation now. Such a pressure situation. Oh!
Good serve. That's quality. Serve confidence as well. He knew he was delivering the serve, and then looking for the next shot. Very good. Another good serve. Courageous as well, not afraid to lift straight to invite the hit onto him.
Counter-attacking now. Notice when it's got this tight, there's not too many touches coming in. It's all sort of real firepower.
Bang, bang, yeah. Yep. Ferguson was here, what would he say? Well, it's that time. That's what he would say. It's 20 all.
Oh!
Oh, bad serve.
Come on!
Will Shakespeare was here, say, cometh the moment, cometh the man.
I'm sure that's what Alec Ferguson would have said as well. So, match point to put the number three seeds out. Look at that.
Oh, I think he should have been on that earlier.
Should have been, yeah. Mistake.
One thing I could not understand there was Briggs on his second smash there was having to go back for it. Oh, that's a poor lead.
That's a very nervous lead. That's what that was for me. Although I thought he was very confident when he was serving earlier there. But that was a very nervous lead. Nowhere near out. Fault serve called. 22 all. He's not happy. Wants to ask the service judge why, but she's gestured it was too high. Or racket header above the hand, I think it was.
It's a nice serve. Oh. Well, there's some nervous play coming on here now, Dan. 23-32.
Game point.
Oh, superb from the Dane. Look at that. How sharp.
Service over. This is so good. That was game point.
You're not seeing much nerves from him, are you?
Yep. He's confident. I think if I was the English boy, I might jump this. Well, I don't mean move before he hits it. All the pressure on the front. I can deliver the whole serve because he's confident. Game point again for the number three seeds to take us to a third set. The one thing no one in the hall wants, a third set. Just with the time for the quarterfinals. I'm just joking, it's enthralling stuff here.
That was a good get.
That was a lovely shot.
From Wolfenden, that was a great get.
And who made the mistake of man of the match so far?
Second game, Peter Briggs and
now how did they react to that? They had match points. Number three seeds won in a very, very tight match indeed, 25-23 in the second set. So now, Ray, who's your money on for the third set?
I think it's one of those on how well the New Zealand boy can react in this serve match to me. Because I'm seeing three very experienced players on there that are used to this sort of competition. Wolfenden and Briggs, I know they've had a partnership for a long while, played junior badminton together. What people might not know is the Dane would be in a club system where he gets matches of the highest quality 2 to 3 times a week, so he would actually be used to this type of play.
So!
I know this much, Dan, if you or I were in the coaching chair, we'd be saying hit the New Zealand boy. And not that he's a weak player, I think he's a very good player.
He is very good, but he's the weaker of the two here.
And
I'm going to stick my neck out and say I'm a giraffe. No. I'm taking the two English boys for the third set. That's a lovely shot. I think they have gained a lot of confidence from winning the second set.
So!
But I'm vicious there, but very good defence from Dean.
But also good at reading. Yeah. Very good at reading.
Yeah, and his handwriting's not bad either. And his arithmetic is top notch. Oh no, it's very good. Read it well.
Oh, look at that for a shot. And to me, that's one of the best shots of the match. And we've been criticising, but he's just played it onto the player's chest. Very difficult thing to do. Takes a lot of skill.
Come on. Service over. Ball.
Not something we've seen very much in the match, that. Seen lots of good serving.
I think it may be the first serve that's went into the net in the three sets.
Which is fantastic serving.
That is superb play, superb. Yes, so young Dane read it very, very well. Moving forward, we rack it up and pick the gap.
And it played two deceptive shots before that. I mean, just didn't put a foot wrong in that rally. This is a style they want to really cut down, really put the sharp angles in, which you can't counter-attack and let the net player in to kill it. So that's one of their classic types of rally, that. Well, known this sort of match, Dan, no one can afford any lapses. A lapse and
you've got a run of points, I guess.
A run of points would go immediately. So these sharp shots they look for.
Good change there. Good change. It looks as if I may have to change myself and take the Dane and the New Zealand boy.
Can't do that. Pick your side.
The change there, they were just moving them round the back, until the Dane decided he was just going to play a block straight. The pressure wasn't on the front of the court there.
So that's power.
So!
That's a little bit lucky. Better lucky than good. They're all good here.
Point here that the Dane could have hit that harder if he wanted to, but he's varying the pace of the smash. It didn't work in that rally, but he's not just giving them one type of smash. See what I mean, Dan? The New Zealand boy, he played a really good shot, but then didn't cover it well.
Come on.
Okay, won the point, but didn't cover it. So now they're 2 points adrift. Now you really want to change.
No, I'm changing. No, no, I'll stick with the English lads. They'll feel confident at the turn. The one on this.
Superb play.
Another net. Come on.
There were some get backs there that were unbelievable. I mean, they were virtually knockoffs from the net and they still got them back.
I was going to ask you to define what a get back was there.
Well, one that you shouldn't
get back.
Back.
That's right. Although they're 8-10 down, if I was the English lads, I'd be saying we just need to be close. We've won in that side. That was a lovely serve and a lovely return.
Go! Go! Yeah! 11-8 interval. Change that.
Well, notice how I haven't picked my winner because I can't. I think it's too tight.
Yeah, it's anybody's game. Well, any of the two pairs that are out there, anyway. I'm still going for the English boys. They've been in these situations before. Hopefully they'll come through as the number three seeds.
I think the two coaches might stand a chance. You've got Anthony Clark and you've got Nathan Robertson.
Court one, 20
both been
seconds.
World finalists.
Court one, 20 seconds.
Good to see England using this experience of these great players. Let's hope it pays off.
Right. 11, 8, play.
Been so difficult to kill that shuttle from the back. It's a front man who really makes a play.
Yeah, that's your job at the back of the court, to hit the areas that you're going to get replies that your partner at the front can finish it. And I mean, Billy Gillon looked good for 10 years.
Absolutely right. I hope he's listening.
I hope so.
And I agree.
I'm sure Billy would.
14-8 now. That's a big lead now. If anyone is into gambling, all you've got to do is listen to Dan, who he thinks he's going to win. And
put the money on the other pair. Could this be a comeback?
9-14.
Serving so important here, so important.
Cut it out, come on.
There again, he hit a bush, it hits the net cord, but he was so confident, the racket was up so early, looking for the next one, and he knew he was going to finish it. Aye again.
10-15.
5 points is quite a lot in the rally point system, though, Dan.
Yeah, it's.
Oh!
The 4 points isn't nearly as much.
11-15.
About 80%. So good at the front.
Yep, look at that.
There was deception there.
Come on! Out.
And for me, he's the one that's made the difference in this match. He's commanded the front third of the court brilliantly. Better than anyone else on the court.
Yeah, I agree with that. It's not often I agree with you, but I agree with you there. Would you agree with that? That was in. That was well in.
I don't think so. I thought it was outside the line.
Challenge, that would be a challenge. However, it's for
you can't challenge. It's not Hawkeye.
I can challenge. That's a good serve.
Oh, that's a busted string.
a chance lost.
It's quite a lot, 17-12.
It is 5 points.
It is 5 points. Back to the 5 points.
Yep.
And quite fortunate to get that point with a busted string. Front of that court.
18, 13. So quick, I can't believe the English boys are even trying to go through.
Well, that's what you'd actually use as a tactic. You'd say, well, go over him, or when he's at the net, don't play there.
Yes, man! Come on!
19-13. Well, Dan, you've made another great call for a match here. Well done.
Thank you. Kiss of death.
Oh.
Show! Come on!
And I think he's saying to us there, Dan, that he can play at the back as well as the front. He's a great player.
Yeah. So it's match point for them. See the English boys pulling this back. One mistake and they're out. So I'm sure the Danes will just keep the pressure up, keep the shuttle in. The Dane and the New Zealand boys
get the attack.
It's a good shot back across.
15-20.
But they should have done it much earlier. Put him under pressure much earlier.
This is the difficult one coming up. One match point saved.
Probably the first mistake we've seen make him make in the net. But 4 points. Your odds are pretty good here. Better than a last minute goal. Oh, that was a good shot. Shuttle's gone. And that's such a tough one there. I mean, they were solid on defence, but defence against attack is always going to lose.
Yep, and he didn't need to lift that. When you said the shuttle had gone, he didn't need to lift it. He could have played a straight net shot. But that's a Dane and New Zealand boy through, just as I predicted. Through to the quarterfinals. Here at the Emirates Arena.
My mate Dan is never wrong, I'm telling you.
So, Leighton Davis mould. 21-13, 23-25, 21-16.
Super game. Super game.
Absolutely a riveting game of men's doubles. And we'll see you all back here for the quarterfinals. So we will be back from 5 o'clock until the close of play this evening. Thank you for watching.